Good day, sir. I'm Jhon Arron J, Inot, your BSN freshman student of late in Normal University San Isidro campus under Entrepreneurial Behavioral Management subject. Here is my video recitation presentation. This is the first question. How an entrepreneur works to the businessman? An entrepreneur is someone who first initiates a product or a business idea. And a businessman is a person who runs the business undertaking an original business idea. An entrepreneur is the one who gives an idea or layout to a businessman. And the businessman will follow the entrepreneur offer because he knows that it will be good for his company. Entrepreneur like as a teacher, and the businessman is like of a student because the entrepreneur teaches what he also knows about the business. The second question is different behavior or attitude of an entrepreneur. The first one is flexibility. As an entrepreneur, you must be flexible in your life. Failure is inevitable. It is necessary to be flexible to have such difficulties and the downfall of your business. Second is integrity. As an entrepreneur, you must be able to showcase honestly integrity to others. In vendors, consumers, and investors must have faith in you of regardless the sort of business they want to start. Next is strong work ethic. Starting a business from the bottom and becoming a successful business owner is not as simple. A new enterprise requires many hours of hard effort, frustration, innovation, and monitoring. Next is passion. It is given that in everything we do, we must be passionate about it. If we love what are we doing, even though we feel exhausted with too much workload, it is still so satisfying. Next is bravery. Entrepreneurs are only human. They feel fear, just like everyone else. Fear of failure and fear that their creation or idea will not be enforced. The next discussion is under module 3. First is gender. If the leadership views both as equal, then a culture of teamwork will be entrenched because everybody's input is taken in. If the company regards men as a superior to women, a negative culture of disrespect towards women may from leading to low moral among women. Second is region. The country or area where an organization operates from also determines its values, beliefs, and attitude. The environment you operate in does affect company culture as you might have to align your values and behavior to others. Third is organization strategy. To fully achieve these strategic goals and plans, the company culture must support the business plan. Fourth is industry. The industry you're in very much determines what culture an organization takes. In the financial industry, a caution and safety culture will be the norm due to the many financial guidelines. An organization is supposed to adhere to its leadership. The behavior and character of the top management go a long way in determining an organizational culture. Employees are likely to behave as they see their leader acting. The role of leadership in determining organization culture cannot be overemphasized. Last is employees. What kind of individuals you are will affect the corporate culture. An employee's attitude, behavior can influence others, leading to a bad company culture. So be careful who you are. The next question is, how organizations live longer? The organization live longer when organizations strive to achieve their objectives. They may live far beyond the tenure and even the life of their individual members, unless they are severely mismanaged or are forced to close. The third question is, when can say that that organization is powerful for a human being? Whether this tool is applied for the accomplishment of tasks, or for problem solving, or for whatever purposes, it is satisfying some human need. The fourth question is, why divisional structures are very important for organization? Because the divisional or departmental organization involves the grouping of people or activities with similar characteristics into a single department or unit. The fifth question, give the different role and function of the line and staffing of organization. First is general staff. This group has a general background that is usually similar to executive and serve as assistant to top management. They are not specialists and generally have no authority or responsibility of their own. Second is specialist staff. Unlike the general staff, who general assists only one line executive. The specialized type provides example of advisory capacity, service capacity, and control capacity. The sixth question is how the key elements works of organization. It has six elements: work specialization, departmentalization, chain of command, the span of control, centralization versus decentralization, and last is formalization. And the seventh question is what are the employees' role in the organization? First is promote company culture. Employees have a role to promote good company culture. As a brand ambassador, they have a part to play in portraying the positive attributes of the company they work for. Next is create and review organization culture. Employees have a role to create the kind of culture they would like to work from. For example, if they want a friendly and open system, everyone has a part to play in ensuring that all feel welcome to say what they want and can be helped in case that help. Question number 8. Why committee structure is important to organization? A committee or a task force is the most important form of a formal group appointed by the management to perform certain functions or tasks. Committees and task force have become more and more necessary and important as the organization grows larger and more complex. And the next question is, explain the advantage and disadvantage of committee in the organization. The example of advantage is pooling of opinions. The members bring in different backgrounds, various viewpoints and abilities. Second is improved cooperation. They are willing to cooperate and coordinate, especially when they become aware of the rule and how their decisions are going to affect the entire organization. Third is motivation. From a human standpoint, the biggest advantage of committees may be increased motivation and commitment derived from participation in the committee, deliberation in their likely and important organizational affairs. Next is representation. Since the committee members may have different interests and opinions that may be opposed to each other, the process of committee deliberation gives critical viewpoint and balanced outcome of these different representations. Dispersion of power. While autocratic authority makes decision-making and implementation faster and easier, it may lead to misuse of power and wrong decisions. Next is executive training. The committee provides an excellent training ground for young executives. They also provide opportunities for personal development that individuals may not be able to get on their own. Next is continuity. Most committees do not replace all of their members at some time, so that some new members join to replace some old members while the other members remain, and thus the continuity of operation is maintained. Next is communication. A committee can be an excellent forum for management and workers to have simultaneous communication and discuss matter of common interest in an atmosphere of goodwill and understand and reach some mutually benefiting conclusion. That is better chances of recommendation to be accepted. A committee recommendation is much more likely to be accepted than individual recommendation. Disadvantage committees. Number 1, time and cost. The very structure of the committee is costly affair in terms of money and time. The nature of the committee is such that everyone has an equal chances to speak out, to take part in discussions. And this can vary time consuming. Second is compromise. Usually, there is a tendency to present anonymous decision, and hence a majority viewpoint is taken as representative even the minority viewpoint is valid. Third is personal prejudice. Sometimes, winning an argument or getting back at somebody for personal reasons may give the problem a secondary priority, thus deducting the strength of the decision. Fourth is log rolling. This term is coined for willing and dealing with political interests and purposes. Fifth is the strain on interpersonal relations. In committee meetings, there is a tendency that everybody wants to please everybody else. Otherwise, and this pressure within the committees can stain working relations outside the committee too. Last is lack of effectiveness. Certain issues are better solved by individuals rather than the committees.
This is the sample of organizational structure. And this is the structure of Nomura Company. And this is the President and Group CEO, Kentaro Okuda. And the Representative Executive Officer and Deputy President, Tomoyuki Taraguchi. And this is the head of retail, Satoshi Arai. Head of wholesale, Stephen Ashley. And the head of investment management, Yoshihiko Namura. Head of content company and sustainability development, Chitoro Yumi. Head of future innovation company, Hajime Ikeda. And this is corporate. We have Chief Financial Officer and Investor Relations, Takumi Kitamura. Next is Chief Risk Officer, Sotaro Kato. Next is Chief Administrative Officer, also known as CAO, Jonathan Lewis. And we have Chief Strategy Officer, Toro Otsuka. This is the Head of Corporate, also known as CCO, Tomoyuki Teraguchi. And last, the Public Policy and Regulatory Engagement, Head of China Committee and Chief Health Officer, Toshiyasu Iliyama. That's all. Thank you.